Hey everybody, it's Henry Steele, and this is the first video I'm doing of the brand new year, 2020 or 2020. Think of that, 20 years into the new century or millennium, to be honest with you. I remember 20 years ago, the firework displays that were going off literally around the entire world, every hour on the hour. When the next time zone would ring in the new year, they had these huge displays. It was really, really something cool and something profound when you think about it. I mean, that's a unique point in history, really, because at that point in time, 20 years ago, the fireworks, the displays for the New Year's, that was for entering not just the new year and not just the new decade, like we just did this past new year. Was also not just a new year, but a new decade. But it was also for the new century and the new millennium. That's crazy when you think about it. So those of us who are able, blessed enough to be there at this point in time, or I should say that point in time, it's really a cool thing, I think. So, but anyway, I wanted to go back to page 60 in Gann's 45 Years in Wall Street. Because judging by a few things that I've read and things that I've received, it's quite obvious that people aren't taking a hint, I guess you could say, and digging deeper into things. And, I mean, I'm sure quite a few of you are, but some of you aren't. So I'm going to nudge a little bit further here before I move on to a completely different subject for my next video later this week or maybe early next week. I'm not really sure. So let's look at this. Let's read the first page in chapter 7 of Gann's book, 45 Years in Wall Street. The title of this part of the book, or of the chapter, I guess we could say, is Dow Jones 30 Industrial Average 3-Day Chart Moves. Now, we talked about that a bit in the last video that I did, the very last video of 2019. So if you haven't seen that, go back and watch it. It's the video that came right before this. Says, my reason for using the Dow Jones 30 Industrial Averages as a trend indicator is not because the Dow theory is working perfectly, but that these industrial averages do indicate the trend of most of the individual stocks. However, the time period on some individual stocks will run out sooner than the averages on the upside, and some will run out later. The same in the bear market. Some stocks will make low sooner by several months and some later than the averages. But the averages are a good guide to the dates when final highs and lows will be reached, and they are important in getting resistance levels for buying and selling prices. Okay. Did you hear that? Reread that by yourself if you have not already. The railroads are slowly becoming obsolete and do not work in harmony with the industrial averages anymore. The public utility averages are in strong position and work more in harmony with the industrial averages than the rails do. That's actually really important to understand. And if you can really start to pull that apart, it might be very helpful for you. But I'm not going to do that for you. So we'll move on. My advice is to keep up the Dow Jones 30 Industrial Averages and follow the trend of these stocks, and then watch individual stocks that conform to the same trend and trade in them. The percentage between the railroad averages and the 30 industrial averages has not been maintained the same during the past few years because industrial stocks in most cases on advances are stronger and advance faster than the rails. Therefore, it is folly to try to watch the rails to confirm with the industrials as based on the Dow theory. But the thing to do is to watch individual stocks that show strong or weak positions and trade in them, and use the industrial averages as a trend indicator, applying all the rules which I have given. Okay, now at this point we get to the four lines here that we looked at in the previous video. It says the averages are not a true average. Okay, read that and consider it important. From 1897 to 1914, they are figured on the basis of 12 stocks. Now, we already looked at, or I already pointed to, basically told you what that means. Then in December 1914, they were changed to 20 stocks and later changed to 30 stocks. That's extremely important. And something else that's very important, remember I told you that Gann's main method of hiding things in plain sight, so to speak, is to take something that actually happened, something that was really historical, or something that is in fact something, and then use it as a MacGuffin almost, something where it's important to the story, but you might not really realize it unless you're already in the know and you already have information. So this is one of the reasons why I say it's important. If you really want to unlock Gann stuff, you can do it all by yourself, and you just have to study things like astronomy, astrology, numerology, ancient systems, geometry. That's an important one. Not just the mathematics of geometry, but the philosophy of geometry also. And all of that stuff is easy to find online, so just do searches for it. You can get it for free or you can pay for it. That's up to you, but you're going to have to decipher, you're going to have to ingest it and make it part of your knowledge base in order to start really being able to look at things like this and going, oh, I see what he did there. You understand? So anyway, this is important. We saw why it was important in the last video, but if you pay close attention, you need to start digging for things. And one of the examples of that is Gann used a piece of history. This is the Dow Jones Industrial Average history laid out in basic right here. It started with 12 stocks, it went up to 20 stocks, and then it went to 30 stocks. But guess what? If you'll actually research that, the dates that Gann's giving here are not really very accurate. So think about that for a second. I wonder why that is. So anyway, if we're looking at specific cycles that Gann is calling the industrial cycles and laying out the basis for them right here, or the starting point to get these averages, and then he's telling you the averages, these averages are not a true average, and he's telling you that they're not going to work perfectly in sync with the stocks, that there are some that it will come close to and some that it won't. What, I mean, if stop and think about that, what is he trying to tell you there with these particular cyclical things that he's pointing out? So that's what I want you to think about. Of course, if you're interested, if you don't care, then don't worry about it. It's not something to waste your time on if you're not interested in it. But if you are, spending time studying it would be very helpful to you, I think. Anyway, we could go on here and read more, but it's not really going to cover anything else than I already did and wanted to point out in this particular video already. So with that in mind, I'm going to go ahead and end the video here, and I will do the next video probably in a few days when I get a chance to do that. So I hope everyone had a wonderful New Year celebration and they continue to have a very blessed and happy 2020.